Where to start talking about Ireland? It's historical, it's a modern, it's mystical all at the same time. There's so much to this country, and where else to start than the capital city of... Here's the thing about Dublin. I feel like a lot of people misinterpret this city. Well, most people misinterpret Ireland as a whole. With its incredible rich history and rivers that go through the city, like this one, River Liffey, it surprises people to know that Dublin has the youngest population in all of Europe. It's booming with a new face of a culture that cares about its historical background while also renovating Dublin with a new color. And lots of it. There's lots of color here. Few small things I noticed is how all the signs in Dublin are in Irish and in English, and the amount of cobblestone roads that are just about everywhere you look. Both of these things bring the old and new of the city together. Just like many big cities, Dublin moves fast and you've got to keep up with it in order to stay ahead. Luckily, the tram gets you to places fast, trains are a great way to see the sights of Ireland, and the bus is good too. But as much as Dublin moves fast, it's also not afraid to relax when it needs to. Everywhere you go, there's hundreds of different pubs, and I mean hundreds of different pubs, maybe thousands. But also quaint cafes where you can just sit down in a park somewhere, relax, drink a coffee, I don't know. Markets down different alleyways, and street performers alike just about everywhere you go, just to enjoy the nicer parts of life. If you're looking for some particularly great places to check out, try to see St. Patrick's Cathedral, which is really, really big and has an incredibly rich history. And how could you not take a trip to Trinity College and see the Book of Kells and the library? With over 6 million books perfectly organized in here since 1500s, it's really an incredible sight that you cannot miss. Also, it feels like all the statues are looking at you and it's kind of weird, but you know what? It's really cool. All this helps make Dublin one of the coolest cities in all of Europe. But as much as I love Dublin, it's the countryside and the smaller cities that make Ireland so beautiful. The small towns in Ireland are filled with so much mystical magic that people think of when they think of Ireland. It's beyond relaxing. The countryside is incredible because you'll be walking around the small towns and out of nowhere you'll find a castle, a thing that's been around here for centuries. There's really cool beach towns like Bray, with the hotels and houses on the beach, mountains and the shore, they're all right next to each other. Enjoy a good game of cricket or bocce, or just walk around and enjoy the sights of the beaches of Ireland. Another cool town is Doolin. Not only is this the fantasy town with cool cafes and houses and ice cream shops everywhere, you can also get a taste of the beautiful greenery and farm life of Ireland. There's sheepdogs herding sheep, which is truly an exciting sight. But you can see tons of ruins for old castles and buildings from the Ireland of long ago. And who could forget a trip to Ireland without a trip to the Cliffs of Moher? These cliffs get up to about 702 feet. You may recognize these from movies like The Princess Bride or Harry Potter and the Half-Blood Prince. Honestly, this is one of the most majestic and stunning places on the planet, especially seeing the birds flying around in the mysterious caves. You can get an awesome view from the boats, or you can go to the top of the cliffs and go,
"Hey, I'm on top of the cliffs."
The highest point of the cliffs is here at O'Brien Tower. It's been around here for hundreds of years, showing off Ireland's most beautiful and inspirational majestic views. And this is what makes this country, Ireland, one of the coolest countries in the world.
So yeah, if you want to be inspired, come to Ireland.